JRay 501 here, Nuclear Information and Resource Service. This is a very proactive, take action now kind of resource site. I invite everyone to come in here and be empowered to take a stand against what is going on in the United States. The very first one, dated July 28th, 2011, Protect the Grand Canyon, Stop Nuclear Loans, and a Lesson from Germany. Dear friends, two particularly interesting articles came through my email today and I wanted to share them with you. This one gives a short but quite good history of the German anti-nuclear movement, which, as you know, is succeeding in its goal of moving Germany away from nuclear power and toward a clean energy future. I particularly ask you to note this time in June 2011, Germany became the first industrialized nation to commit to abandoning the atom as an energy source once and for all by 2022. It's a move unthinkable without the unremitting pressure of Germany's tenacious anti-nukes movement. A move unthinkable without the unremitting pressure of a tenacious anti-nuclear movement. That is why NIRS does what we do, why we send you these alerts and urge you to take part. We need to be tenacious and unyielding as the German anti-nuclear movement has been for years, and we need to put the same kind of pressure on decision makers in the U.S. Sometimes it may seem we send out too many actions, or perhaps we seem repetitive, asking you to send in letters on an issue you've already acted on, to send in your umpteenth letter on nuclear loans. But remember that we are countering an industry with far more resources and more lobbyists than we could ever muster. The industry is meeting with Congress members and administration people every day. Those people are hearing the industry's viewpoint. If they're going to hear ours, the majority of the American public's, we have to do it ourselves. We do our best to provide you with the tools and information to do so, but it only works when we all participate. Okay, so in April, thousands of you responded to our alert urging the Obama administration to prevent uranium mining around our great national treasure, the Grand Canyon. And the administration heard your comments and those of tens of thousands of others. And in June, the Interior Department decided to place a 20-year moratorium on new uranium mines there. It was a good, great victory. But as Representative Grijalva warns, some House Republicans are attempting to overturn the Interior Department's decision even before its final implementation and require the government to hand out leases for new uranium mines. We need to protect this victory and the Grand Canyon itself. Please tell your Congress members here to reject any and all efforts to open up the area around the Grand Canyon to uranium mining. So, here, protect the Grand Canyon from uranium mining. There's a little bit of information about it. And if you put your zip code in here, they'll take care of the rest for you. They'll send off your voice for you. It doesn't get any simpler than that, right? This is another article. GOP lawmakers have Canyon under siege, dated July 27th, 2011. It's not too dramatic to say the Grand Canyon has been under siege from mining claims for several years now. Unfortunately, several of my Arizona congressional colleagues have taken stands that would make sure that siege continues. As I wrote in a May 4 letter to U.S. Interior Secretary Ken Salazar, there are at least 8,500 mining claims near the canyon. That's up from the 100 claims on file in January as of 2003. That's why June 20 was such a big day in history of American conservation. In a ceremony I was proud to attend, Salazar said, he will recommend withdrawing more than 1 million acres around the canyon from mining claims for the next 20 years. It was, in every sense, a huge deal. That announcement, unfortunately, wasn't the end of the discussion. Salazar's proposal won't be formalized until the end of the year, and in the meantime, Republicans in Congress, including Republican Reps Jeff Flake, Trent Franks, and Paul Gosar, have been busy. The most important issue to watch is an unusual amendment to this year's Interior Department's funding bill. The amendment says Interior can't implement Salazar's withdrawal of those acres around the Grand Canyon, even though this is a spending bill which isn't allowed to make policy. It just goes ahead and says Interior can't do its job. Who wrote this amendment? According to his own July 12 press release, it was Representative Flake. Just as bad, Reps Franks and Gosar wrote a May 16 letter to House Natural Resources Committee Chairman Doc Hastings of Washington, calling Salazar's proposal a serious national security threat. Wow, these guys are on crack. And we're paying for it. I'm betting they'll support the Flake Amendment when they get the chance. What makes Representative Flake's effort especially strange is that American corporations, or even our nuclear power sector, wouldn't really benefit if it passed. Much of the uranium extracted by Denison Mines Corp., a Canadian company with multiple mining leases in the Grand Canyon area, is exported to South Korea, where Korea Electric Power Corp. has an ownership stake. Here we go. Follow the money. Here's where the truth comes in. Has nothing to do with protecting America or one of the most incredible features on the face of the planet, the Grand Canyon. Has nothing to do with anything sacred. It has everything to do with money. How will protecting the Grand Canyon from a South Korean-owned Canadian mining firm create a national security crisis? The Franks Gosar letter doesn't really say. It does say that withdrawing the land from mining claims a political gamesmanship. I'll let readers decide how they feel about that. Action on this amendment will probably come soon. The funding bill has been approved by the House Appropriations Committee, but hasn't been to the full House for a vote. If it passes, it will almost certainly include this language. Unless someone in the Senate works to get it taken out, it will be in the final bill that goes to the President. And, you know, we know what that's all about. This is all part of a bigger ideological campaign to eliminate environmental protections Republicans disagree with in principle. It isn't about helping the economy. It's about not believing the government should protect the environment, period. Arizona doesn't want to open the Grand Canyon for mining, drilling, or any other kind of disruption. The canyon isn't just a pile of rocks or a vein of minerals waiting to be turned into cash. It's the crown jewel of our national park system and one of the most beautifully recognizable features on the entire planet. This amendment would put the needs of millions of Grand Canyon visitors, not to mention the Grand Canyon itself, somewhere below the needs of the mining CEOs. I'm squarely against this tactless, unnecessary corporate giveaway. I think the people of this state and this country agree with me. I'd like to know from Rep. Flake what his proposal is supposed to accomplish and who he's earmarking this for. Let's end this siege on the Grand Canyon once and for all. Now, if that doesn't piss some people off, and you know what? If you can't sign to have this thing thrown out, if you can't do it for yourself, then do it for your children or for your grandchildren. Please, please, don't just sit back and complain. We have a chance to do something, and it's as simple as putting your zip code right here. If not, and they continue to do uranium mining there, then keep your mouth shut and don't complain about it.